All right. Well, hello and welcome. Welcome and hello. Today is Thursday, which means that it is vlog day. I got a sweet new haircut. I have some great, great beer that I'm really looking forward to. This is going to be an action-packed vlog as per usual. We're going to do some shout-outs and some first impressions. We're going to do some retro vaping. And at the end, instead of viewer mail, I'm going to try to squeak in some good music. We're also going to be talking about that VapeBoss app. We have a lot of stuff to talk about. A lot of shout-outs. The shout-out section just keeps getting longer. It just keeps growing and growing and growing and growing. I don't have any advocacy stuff to talk about today, but that doesn't mean that it's not going on. So as always, catch up with organizations like CASA, SAFADA, and the Vaping Militia to see what's going on, what's going down in your area. I heard that there's things going through in Texas. I heard Indiana is at it again. There was an update on the Nevada bill. The 30% tax got thrown out. Everybody showed up, and it was fantastic. Want to give a big shout out to my buddy Rick up in Nevada, as well as my good friends Nina, Chad, and Shelly from Nevada Vapor Supply, as well as Dennis from Nevada Vapor Supply. Evidently everybody went down to the hearing, to the health committee meeting, and got to speak and testify. And that's, good God, that's what I like to see. How's everything look? How's everything sound? Good, good. On we go into the vlog. First thing I want to talk about is beer. So, oh baby, good Lord, I'm excited about this. I bought some beer. What I'm going to do in a future vlog, maybe not the next vlog, but definitely in an upcoming vlog, I'm going to grab my GoPro. We're going to drive down to the BevMo all together, and we're going to go beer shopping, and I am going to buy some beer, and I'm very excited about it. I love going beer shopping, so I figured I would just take all of my vlog viewers with me, and we're gonna go do some beer shopping. But the local place down the street from me has a very good selection of beer, as well as, you know, hard alcohol, wine, everything like that. It looks, from the outside, it looks like a convenience store, but when you get on to the inside, huge selection of craft beer and regular beer, and they had one bottle left of this. Picked up a bottle of Firestone 2015 Sukaba. Oh, I'm so excited for this. If we go over to the Beer Advocate website, which is what I like to do. I like Beer Advocate quite a bit. The Sukaba has a perfect 100% world-class rating. Oh, my God, I can't believe it. I'm so excited about this, and technically, it's not a beer. It is a barley wine ale, which Firestone has the habit of just creating their own sort of categories. It's like the Sticky Monkey was a North Coast quad. That's what they called it. There's no such thing as a North Coast quad, but they just called it. They're like, oh, this Sticky Monkey, yeah, that's a North Coast quad. They just invented this. So barley wine ale. I've never heard of another barley wine ale. I've heard of barley wine, but not with the barley wine ale. This was an expensive brew. $18 for the bottle. I could not be more excited. I love that their bottles come in cardboard boxes. This was literally the last one that they had in the store. Oh, and I'm going to get into it. Let's put this to the side. Oh, look how exciting this is. 2015 Sukaba. Oh, I can't even wait. Barrel-aged barley wine. And they list everything on here, what kind of hops they use. They produced 3,000 cases. British ale yeast. Ugh. Adam Firestone and David Walker. You guys are geniuses. This might... Oh, I need a bottle opener. Give me a second. And for some reason I thought this was a cork. And I got terrified that it was a cork, but it's not. It's actually a bottle opener. So I'm going to have to go run and get a bottle opener real fast. I'll be right back, like you won't even notice. God, do you see how fast I am? It's not that I'm that fast, it's just that my place is that small. Here we go, Firestone Sakaba 2015. I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly. I don't know exactly how it's pronounced. My buddy Brandon, whom we call Meat, he always said Sakaba, so that's what I'm going to call it. I'm going to call it Sakaba, and I just want to drink this out of the bottle, but I'm not going to do that. What I'm going to do instead is pour it into a traditional tulip-style glass, and I'm going to, as always, you know, pour it right over my keyboard, which is always a great idea. It doesn't look super dark. It looks about as dark as that Sticky Monkey did. I'm going to try to get a nice little head on there. Looks very, very carbonated. Nice tan, kind of taupe-colored head. It sort of has a reddish hue to it. The smell of it does, it kind of reminds me of that Sticky Monkey. So this is an English barley wine ale, 100% on Beer Advocate. And I just love finding those beers. And when you see them in the store of something that you know you've been looking for but have never been able to find, and you see it, it's just like you see rainbows coming out of it. It's such a beautiful sight. I'm dying to try this. I want to read one of the top reviewers here. He got it on tap. Pours a dark crimson red brown. Yep, that sounds about right. Small tan head, fades to nothing. The head came out very, very, very fizzy, much like a soda. No lacing whatsoever on the drink down. The smell coming off this is absolutely fantastic. Caramel, toffee, butterscotch, brown sugar, cherry, coconut, earthy, woody. Wow. Wow. All right, so here's to all my vlog viewers. I love you like crazy. Here's to ya. Firestone Sakaba. He was very accurate with the caramel toffee. I get a toffee flavor, but it's very like bitey in my jowls. It really hits me hard there. Well, obviously I'm gonna have to go try to find some more of this. It's very earthy, very cedary. It's like a dense tree bark sort of up front on the finish. On the front of my tongue, I get this like intense, dark, cedary, like tree bark flavor. It is sweet and very carbonated, and I taste that toffiness, that like toffee flavor and butterscotch, like in my jowls. It makes my mouth like salivate, like it's almost like a savory flavor. Oh my God. This is just delicious. The best part about it is it's not like overpowering. It doesn't like come on so intense like some other beers from Firestone, like the Double DBA or the Sticky Monkey is just very, very intense. This is a little bit more mellow, but it's got a very strong, sweet, toffee butterscotch undertones, but it does have that like earthy, woody, like cedary on the up front. It's very carbonated. I have a feeling I'm going to be burping a lot. I apologize right now in advance, Sheik. I don't get a lot of like cherry coconut like he was talking about. But that's just me. This guy says, this is by far the best barley wine I've ever had. 13% alcohol. The aromas and flavors mesh together amazingly well. I have two more of these in my cellar, and I can't wait to see how they age. Yes. What I want to do is track down another bottle of this Sakaba and drink it, like, maybe in a year from now, just to see how it ages. A lot of the Firestone beers, and a lot of craft beers in general, do get better with age. Pardon me, different flavor elements will come out, and they do get better with age. I had a 2012 Double DBA that I drank recently that was just the Double DBA from Firestone is stupid good. It is stupid good. Sakaba, very, very nice. I would love to see how it ages in a year, but yeah, Firestone Sakaba, if you can find some, and you have your beer budget hands. I saw the bottle and I knew without a doubt that I was going to buy it. I saw it and I said, yes, that I will be purchasing that today. And then I saw the price and I went $18 and I went, doesn't even matter. Saw 18 bucks. It could have said $28. I would not even blinked an eye. I would not have even thought twice. about purchasing this. Looking forward to one of the beers that one of my subscribers is sending me, the Hop Slam. Everybody keeps talking about it. My good buddy Joe over at Amber Juice, he keeps talking about it. He says it's the best beer he's ever had. I'm very excited to try some of this Hop Slam. Evidently, it's brewed in Michigan, and so down here in Southern California, it's not readily available. So hopefully I'll be able to get my hands on some of this Hop Slam. Really looking forward to that. Sakaba, though. Sakaba, dude. It's good. Now, what do I have that would pair well with that? Maybe this. We're going to talk about this in the first impressions. But I have a feeling the Skull and Crossbones might pair just perfectly with the with that Sakaba. Oh yeah. There's three juices that I like to vape while I'm drinking beer. One of them is the Namber Juice Donut Pounder. Donut Pounder goes amazing with a lot of beers. The other one is from RJ Vapes. It's their RYM. It's a very light tobacco flavor. I like that. The other one is Vigilante, Skull and Crossbones, Russ and Ashley, who I love to death. They make the Skull and Crossbones, and it also pairs very, very well with maybe some more obscure beers. It's not like my every beer, but I will usually vape either Donut Pounder or RYM with beer, as well as the Skull and Crossbones. It's just, it pairs very, very well. They're kind of more hearty juices, except for the RYM, and there's something about the cinnamon in the Donut Pounder that goes amazing with beer, and there's something in that Skull and Crossbones that's like a caramely, like toffee flavor that pairs really well, almost as good as the Donut Pounder with beer. So that's what I got on the beer front right now. That was long. I feel like that was a long segment for the beer. Yes, that was long. We're going to get into some shout-outs now. First shout-out I have to do is Cloud Kicker Society. Holy crap. Met all the guys from Cloud Kicker Society at the OC Vape Meet, and they're all just super nice guys. They're really into the community. They're really into this vaping movement, and they've created, you know, they have their own, pardon me, sorry Sheik, sorry Robin Stewart, you're still wearing my Dave Brocky shirt. You need to change your shirt, man. That is gross. Cloud Kicker Society made me up some t-shirts, and I'm just floored at their generosity. They sent me 6 t-shirts, 2 extra larges, 2 larges, and 2 mediums of this shirt, and I don't know what I'm going to do with them yet. Obviously, one of the shirts I'm just keeping for myself. I might keep 2 for myself just because I'm a greedy son of a bitch, but the other ones I might take out to Tampa with me to give away. On behalf of the Cloud Kicker Society, we might give these away at Tampa, but this is their logo, okay? You see this? Cloud Kicker Society, Grim Army Chapter. And they went ahead and threw my Grim Army logo on the sleeve. Holy crap, that is cool. And then they have their, you know, sort of their ohm symbol on this sleeve. And on the back, Cloud Kicker Society Original Social Club 2009. With their sick logo. This is a medium, so I'm not gonna wear this because it's far too small, but it's like this army green color. How cool is that? Grim Army Chapter, and they threw my Grim Army logo on the sleeve. Fuck, that is just so cool. That is just so cool. I will definitely be wearing one of these shirts in Tampa. Additionally, I'm gonna try to bring the rest of them to give away in Tampa. I'm bringing the vape mats to North Carolina, and I'm going to bring at least a couple of these t-shirts to Tampa to give away. But you guys in the Cloud Kicker Society, you're so fucking cool. You're so generous. I really appreciate this a lot. Support them, absolutely. You should support them. Now, last week I mentioned Israel Rathburn, and I didn't know who that was, and I wanted to give him a shout out. Turns out he is a YouTube guy, and I had a feeling he was a YouTube guy. I am shouting him out. He started up a YouTube channel, and he used to do two-minute reviews, two-minute vape reviews. He did the Big Dripper clone, the Sigelli 100 watt, the Orchid version 1, two-minute vape reviews. And then he switched over somewhere along the way to real quick vape reviews. None of his videos are longer than 5 minutes long. I know Kevin from VP Live is friggin' in love with this guy. He just wants to have an affair with Israel Rathburn because Kevin is that whole like, I don't have the attention span. I can't watch P. Bisardo videos. I can't watch GrimmGreen videos. 20 minutes long, that's way too long for a video. So, for people like that, for people like you, Kevin, this guy does two-minute vape reviews, and now he's changed it to real quick vape reviews. But they're very well done. They're very professional. He does a little voiceover, shows the products, tells you what you need to know, and that's it. All of them are under 4 minutes, under 5 minutes long, and I'll post a link in the description to this video to where you can check out Israel Rathburn's YouTube channel. A lot of people always ask me what retail stores that stock Namber juice. There's a few, but it's not, you know, crazy. It's not in every city and in every state, but there's one recently, Oshkosh, Wisconsin. A fella named Hunter just picked up the line in Oshkosh, Wisconsin. Try to say that a couple times. Oshkosh, Wisconsin. Dragway Vapors. So shout out to you, Hunter, at Dragway Vapors. I hope your store is incredibly successful. Thank you so much for stocking the Epiclouds. If you're in the Oshkosh, Wisconsin area, head over to Dragway Vapors. Give Hunter a hard time, because that's just funny. I also wanted to give a shout out to Dave, who works at E-Cig Outlet in Muskegon, Michigan. Muskegon, Michigan. So quick shout out to you, Dave, and everybody there at E-Cig Outlet. Keep doing what you're doing. Keep doing your good work. Additionally, I want to give a shout out to Ray. A fellow named Ray emailed me and said he works for Herman Vapes in the UK. And this is going to kind of lead into something else. they are going to be attending the UK Vape Jam on October, on the 8th and 9th of May. Unfortunately, due to circumstances beyond my control, I will not be able to attend the UK Vape Jam this year, but I've heard that there's going to be a big vape meet in Germany as well as France. I would like to get to one of those. Unfortunately, I won't be able to get to the UK the 8th and 9th of May, but I do want to give a shout out to Ray, who works for Herman Vapes, who is going to be there. I also want to give a shout out to Vape News Magazine. You may or may not have seen my new column in Vape News Magazine. It's called Let's Ask GrimmGreen. And it's kind of like viewer mail questions. Like, people have questions about everything from, you know, the future FDA proposals to local legislation to what batteries should I buy, what's wrong with my atomizer, magnets. I mean, it covers a broad spectrum of things, and I'm happy to be a part of it. It's a great organization, and everybody that I've met who works for Vape News Magazine, stellar people, just good people. They are the big sponsor of the UK Vape Jam, and I think this is going to be a great thing for UK vapers, and I know a lot of US vapers and international vapers that are all going to UK for the big UK Vape Jam, and I think that's very, very cool, and I'm excited to be a part of Vape News Magazine. I met Norm through Vape News Magazine, and he does a radio type of podcast, and he interviewed me, and he does a thing called Vape University, which is kind of like an online webinar type of situation about building your vape business and questions that anybody might have. He asked me to be an instructor for it, and I was very, very hesitant because I'm kind of like, what do I really have to offer? I just get on YouTube and I talk about products and I drink beer, and I don't know what I have to offer. But we did my first Vape University this last week. I apologize, scratching. I did my first Vape University seminar this week, and I think it went well. There were some good question and answers kind of at the end. We're talking about what kind of hardware that, you know, local brick and mortar stores could carry, should carry. Things like high-end mods, do they really sell? We talked about China and their constant upgrading of products. It makes no sense. They just keep upgrading them. But anyway, so shout out to Norm, Vape News Magazine, Vape University. Additionally, I got to hang out with Jay and Michael from In the Galaxy podcast. And this is a non-vaping podcast. And they had me on to kind of talk about vaping in the world of technology, and it was really, really fun. We talked about a lot about beer and booze and shower beers, which evidently is a thing. But I'll post a link in the description to where you can listen to that podcast if you'd like to. It's a non-vaping podcast, so it was interesting kind of talking to, you know, Jay. I think his name is Jay. If his name's not Jay, I'm going to feel like an asshole. Michael was not a vapor, and Jay was a vapor, and so it was kind of interesting getting questions from someone who doesn't know anything about vaping, and then talking to someone like hardware-wise, like about vaping. It was just a very interesting, very cool experience, and they're very, very nice guys. I would love to go back on that podcast sometime in the future, and it was good times. 20 minutes, and we're not even done with the shout-outs? Good Lord. I want to give one last shout-out. One last shout out. This is going to be the last shout out. I want to give a shout out to my boy. Shit. My boy. I don't know why I said that. Twisted Messes. Twisted Messes is just a cool dude, and he builds like a fucking sorcerer on atomizers, and he built me. I sent him I talked about this El Cabron previously in a vlog, and so the post holes on this are gigantic, and I wanted something that would take advantage of the huge airflow and of those huge post holes. So I sent it to Twisted Messes, and he put on a dual staggered fused Clapton. He has a build video for it on his YouTube channel, which I'll link to in the description, but this thing looks amazing. It just, the coils just look cool. He sent it to me wicked. I just threw juice on there. The performance has been amazing. The flavor has been completely out of control. I have the El Cabron opened up all the way on the airflow. It is ridiculous. You need all that airflow. The vapor is warm. It is flavorful. It feels dense. I wish I had the patience or the ability to build something like this, because I would put a build like this on every atomizer that I own. It's intense. It is intense. But I've just been loving it. I've been really, really enjoying it. And hopefully when I do a review later for the El Cabron atomizer, this build will still be on there. Of course, I could just mess it all up later on and mess it up. Also want to give a shout out to Squid Dude. He messaged me on Instagram recently. And Squid Dude. He offered to send me over some staple coils, and so I said, ooh, I would love to try to put those on an atomizer, and he's a good guy, and he does sick builds as well. These staple coils are ridiculous, but anyway, his name is Squid Dude, at Squid Dude. It's Squid, O-O-D-E, Squid, O-O-D-E. Go track him down, go find him, follow him, look at his sick builds in addition to Twisted Messes. Such a nice guy. So, 25 minutes in now. Oh, shit. Let's do some first impressions. All right, so what do I have for some first impressions today? So the first thing that I wanted to talk about, and this is going to be quick, the first thing I wanted to talk about is this 5mm Atlantis extension. If you're a fan of the Atlantis, and I am a fan of the Atlantis, it's just a great vape. The Atlantis is awesome. I find myself rocking it at lower wattages. I know 45 watts is low wattage, but I find myself rocking it at a little bit lower wattages these days. I was trying to crank it up to like 60, 70 watts, and it wasn't having it, but 44.5 watts for 5.1 volts on a 5 ohm coil, 0.5 ohm coil, I should say. performance is great, and the one drawback that I always thought to the Atlantis was the juice capacity. So, a company called B-Side Vapors, they sent me over the extension tank, and now there's a couple third-party extension tanks, but this is actually like the official Aspire Atlantis extension tank. So you know it's going to work perfectly with the base. And all it is, you use it on your base with your heads, and it's just an extension. The tank is bigger, the chimney in the center is bigger, and it holds 5 mils of juice, which going from like a 2.5 mil capacity to a 5 mil capacity is huge. I find myself using my Atlantis a lot more with this extension tank on there because I don't need to bring any juice with me if I leave the house. I can just bring my tank and call it good, and I know that I'm not going to plow through all this 5 mils of juice in a couple of hours. So definitely check out B-Side Vapors. I'll post the link in the description. It's B-Side, VAPORS.com. They're the ones that sent this over, and they're carrying the, you know, authentic Aspire 5 mil extension tank. And it's been rad. I mean, I'm not going to do a full review on it, but I'm going to talk about it now, and I'm going to use it a lot. You'll probably see it in future videos on future regulated mods. Also want to give a shout out to 45 Vinyl, and I'll post a link in the description to their Etsy store, but it's 45 Vinyl, and do you see this? Holy crap, that is cool. They do custom vinyl stickers for your mods. They do a Batman symbol? Oh, I want the Batman decal. They do some Adventure Time stuff. They do you know, whatever you want. Boba Fett helmet, Darth Vader helmet, gas masks, skull and crossbones, and then, of course, Stormtroopers. Oh, they do the Punisher, too. And then, of course, the Stormtroopers. I got a couple of these white Stormtroopers, and, of course, one went on my Sigelli 100 Watt Plus because that's the only black mod I have. It's great. It's kind of fantastic. It's kind of so cool and so nerdy, but I want to give a shout out definitely to 45 Vinyl. I'll post a link in the description to their Etsy shop where you can go sticker shopping. It's reasonably priced. They're $4 per, and it's one of those, you know, you put it down and then you peel it off because there's a lot of like little intricate parts, kind of all these right here, these things on the sides. It's all very intricate and delicate, but once it's on there, it's on there, and it's great. I haven't had any issues with it rubbing off or peeling off or anything, and I just like the way it looks, and it makes me want to use my Sigelli 100 Watt Plus even a lot more. And this sticker will remain on here when I do the review video. Not next week, probably the week after that. But shout out to 45 Vinyl. So what else do I have for first impressions? Oh, that's right, the VapeBoss app. That's right, I was going to talk about the VapeBoss app. I'm just throwing this into the first impressions, but there's a new app out. It's free in the Apple Store and free in the Amazon Store. And it's called VapeBoss, and it is, well, it's pretty boss. It's pretty cool. I want to show it to you. So what we're going to do is go up close for a quick short up close time. Let me get some vapor for the toot transition. All right, well, let's talk a little bit about this VapeBoss app. So the app basically just came out yesterday. It came out Wednesday. Today is Thursday. It came out yesterday. It's Wednesday. I have VapeBoss right there, and it's been kind of giving me notifications all day long. One thing that is cool about the VapeBoss app, and there's Cheeksy, it has its own sort of Instagram-style thing, and I'm not following very many people just yet, but if you scroll down, there's Cheeksy Vapes, there's Understudy from the Plumes of Hazard, there's the official VapeBoss thing, which you start off following VapeBoss, but you don't have to follow them, but I'm going to keep following them just because. There's a picture that I posted of the Freak Show RDA, but it's if you're used to Instagram, it's a lot like Instagram. So if you want to like a picture, you go, yep, and it shows you a little VapeBoss logo, and then hashtags and everything also work the same way. So if she hashtagged Grim Army, it'll show you the three pictures now. Not a whole lot of users yet, but it shows you the three pictures now which are using the Grim Army. So that's all well and good. There's the social media aspect of it. Activity, you can see your own profile. That's, if I can tap it, That's my profile. I've posted one picture. I have 13 followers. If you're on the VapeBoss app, just go ahead and follow me. It's good times over here. Oops, nope. That's a text message. We're going to go back to the main profile. This is the main page. You'll always start here on the social media. Then if you look down here at the bottom, there's social, which will take you to the Instagram style thing. And then there's brands and post and then local places and then more. So what we're going to do is start off here with the brands. And it's going to take you to this page, which is a fantastic page. It has juices at the top, mechanical mods, regulated mods, atomizers, clearomizers, RBA, RDAs and RBAs and tanks. So let's just say I'm looking for a new regulated mod. So I'm going to click on regulated mods, and it's going to give you just an obscene list alphabetically of everything you want. So let's go to something that I know is maybe around in my area, just so I can show you how the map function works, which is pretty fantastic. So Aspire, let's go to Aspire CF sub-ohm battery right here. Aspire CF sub-ohm battery. Which color do you want? Well, I want a black one. So it kind of brings you to this page where it shows you all about the battery, it shows you a picture of the battery, and it shows you who on the app has reviewed it. You can write a review. It gives you a whole description of the product. It has reviews, so there's two reviews for it. Tia Vapes is on there, and it shows you the features. It shows you basically everything you need to know about the CF battery, and I did a review for this, and I don't know why my video is not on there, but that's okay. We'll get to that. We'll get to something else later. So what you want to do is you can favorite it. You can add it to your wish list, which you can access at any time. So if you run across something that you really like, you put it in your wish list. I like this. I like the find near me. So if I press this, it shows me that within 100 miles, the Vapor Lounge in Rancho Cucamonga, 97 miles away, has this battery. If I want to drive there, I can get it. I can drive there and I can get it. And you can, the Vapor Lounge, Rancho Cucamonga, you can call them. You can get directions if you click on the store. I think that's a fantastic, little thing. Cancel. Go out, go back, and now you're back to all the products. And it does the same thing with juices. And let's be self-serving here. Let's scroll down to N. Let's see who around me has an amber juice. C, D, E, N. Oh, oops, I passed it. So, what am I looking for? Nick's Blissful Brews? No, although that's delicious. Native American N3. Let's go to Namber Juice Epiclouds. So it has all the Epiclouds on here. And if you want Mom's Pineapple Cake, you can see a picture of the Mom's Pineapple Cake. You can see reviews for it. Cloudy's on there. You can see the description for it. You can see the flavor profile. So if you're like, oh, creamy, you can search later. You can't click on it now, but you can search later for all like creamy or sweet type of flavors. Find near me. I think it's, oh, no, wow. Can't find anything in my area. Well, I know for sure that RJ Vapes has it. So, and I know it's 100 miles from me. The app just launched, so it's gonna be getting added to on a regular basis. But yeah, that's the VapeBoss app up close and personal. And what they're doing is, if you go to the App Store and you search for VapeBoss, which I believe I have already just searched for. Nope. Shoot. Oh gosh, I'm going to have to do this upside down. V A why is typing upside down so hard? Vape space boss B O S S search. Vape Boss. So what they're doing is they're doing custom apps for stores. And if you search for Vape Boss in the App Store, you're going to run across all these shops that have their own version of the Vape Boss app. Vape Dojo, TKO Vapors. I can't read these upside down. Local Vape, this, that, and the other. District, this vape shop, that vape shop. Good Life Vapor. They all have their own versions. Vapors Knoll of the Vape Boss app. So what I did is I downloaded the local vape app right there, and this kind of This is just downloaded. I just downloaded it. There's a little tutorial to get you started. Has sign up, this and that. Tells you how it works, this and that. Learn about our products, this and that. Next, next, next. Okay, okay. And yeah, so if I click sign in, oh shoot, I have to use my same sign in. But the shops have their own thing. And the difference is I don't want to register right now. Okay, fine. Let's just sign up right now. Let's just sign in. My email is nick@grimmgreen.com. My password, which you probably just saw, so I'm going to have to edit that out. So there we go. Now we're in the local vape version of the app. And what the local vape version of the app does is when you go to the brands, it's going to go to their stuff first. So this is what local vape carries. This is local vape's juice menu. Okay. This is the mechanical mods that local vape carries. Each shop is going to be specific to their shop. So if I go the Dot Mod Petri mod, there it is in gold, and local vape has it, and you can get directions to the local vape store. It tells you whether or not it's in stock, and there's reviews for it. You can save it to your wish list, or you can save it to your favorites. You can do all this sorts of stuff through the specific app of the store, which I think is pretty cool. If you're interested in what atomizers local vape has, this is all the atomizers that they have and carry. I think it's pretty cool. I'm excited to start using this VapeBoss app. I've had it for a little bit, and now that it's live, there's going to be actually people posting, and you can follow them and treat it like Instagram. As of right now, there's no other social media connectivity. You can't connect it to your Facebook or to your Instagram or to your Twitter or anything like that. It's kind of its own contained social thing, but download the app, look around, go look at regulated mods, look at whatever you want. I think it's a pretty cool, fun little app for vapers, available in the Android marketplace as well as the iOS app store. So yeah, there it is. VapeBoss app. Woohoo. Normal view now. No, not normal view now. I left out the most important thing. The more button, the more at the bottom lets you navigate. So top 10 juices, the juice finder, my juice box. So this is where you have like your saved juices. If you come across a juice and you're like, oh, I really want to try this, that, and the other, and you put it in your juice box, you can navigate there at any time and see what juices you've saved and see your favorites and see your wish list. There's an Ohm's Law calculator in here, and there you go, the VapeBoss Ohm's Law calculator. So you can put in your resistance, your voltage, your wattage, and calculate all your Ohm's Law stuff that you need to. Additionally, what they included, and I am incredibly thankful, I think it's very, very cool, GrimmGreen, right there. It's in the more. Go over to more, go over to GrimmGreen. That's my YouTube. It's going to have my just direct link to my YouTube. So if you want to just in the app, if you decide you want to watch the Freak Show Atomizer video, yeah, it's going to be right there, and this is still all within the app. You click done, you go back, and now you're back in the more menu. You want to go to social, you want to go to more. The more has basically everything else in it. VapeBoss swag, tutorials, Vape 101, Ohm's Law calculator, your favorites, your wish list, all of this is included in here. So it's a very full, deep, sort of rich application, and yeah, so that's now normal view. So yeah, that's the VapeBoss app. I'm following a few people. I'm following Understudy, Miss Cheeksy, the VapeBoss, couple of people, Plumes of Hazard. There's not a whole lot of people on here, but let's see. Where's my profile? I got 26 followers. If you're on, if you get on the VapeBoss app, go ahead and give me a follow. If you want me to follow your back, I mean, just let me know. I'm not sure who to follow on this. But yeah, I like fun, entertaining news feeds. It's so much more than just a social app, though. The more section is really is really kind of great. Latest reviews on regulated mods. Oh yeah, look at that. There's people already reviewing stuff on here. That's great. Blue Jay Skies just reviewed the Sick Clouds Triple 18650 unregulated box mod. One review. Oh, it's got my vlog on there where I talk about it. It's a mechanical. Can we read the review? Yeah. Oh, and you can include pictures in your reviews. This is great. This, as this grows, I feel like this is really going to be a great resource. Additionally, I mean, I'm a little bit biased because they did include the link to my YouTube channel in the more area, which I'm pretty excited about that. But it's been a fun app to just and you can use the local shops and see what's around you. And they have these, I didn't show this in the up close, but there's like the VapeBoss preferred stores. So if I click on this one, who's this? TKO Vapors in Victorville, California. You can click on the information, get the logo, all the information about the shop. You can call them, see their Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram. You can go to their website. Juices we carry. Look at that. That's cool. They carry vape fuel. I don't know exactly what that is. Pictures of the shops. It's such a fun app. It's a fun, cool app. I'm really excited for a lot more people to get on here so it can become even more flushed out and even more interactive. And I'm looking for people to follow on that Vape Boss app. Next thing I have to do real quick for some first impressions, Congestus. So the Congestus arrived, and it's funny, not funny, maybe unfortunate. I was looking around. I was looking around the internet trying to find an authentic Congestus. The thing is, they're just not around. Every time you search for Congestus 26650 mod, you get clones. Everyone has clones. Nobody has the authentics. So Sasha contacted me on Facebook, and so I went to the Saru Mods website, sarumods.com, and I'll post a link in the description, and they have the authentic Congestus mods in here. So this is, they have the polished brassed, the machined, congested, velvet blasted. So I'm assuming this is a velvet blasted copper Congestus. 26650. It's hitting like crazy, and they give you extension tubes. So if you're feeling crazy, kind of like the Vapor Giant, you can stack two 26650s in here, and it's roughly the size of a large D-cell Maglite. It's giant. It's gigantic. It has that pinky-style switch on the bottom, which has been a little bit fiddly. So far, I've really enjoyed it. I mean, I'm not going to lie, it's been great. The day it arrived, I took it up to Vader Vapor for their cloud comp. And of course, I didn't enter the cloud comp because I don't enter cloud comps. But I enjoyed it. I used it the whole time. I love the 26650 mods for vape mates because you don't really have to worry about your battery life. You just put a freshly charged one in and you're good for a while, for the whole vape meet at least. It's been hitting well. I haven't had any misfires, and it feels very intense, like it's hitting really well. And then you'll kind of notice on here, can you see that? Sent along a 26650 cap for the marquee. So this is the normal sized marquee atomizer in here. I rebuilt it with some diamond wire. It's sitting at about 0.17 ohms, and it just has this big 26650 cap on there to make it look flush with the mod. And if you want to pop this off and put the normal one on there, you can put it on 18650 mod and then it'll sit flush on that, or you can switch out the top cap and put the 26650 sized on there. It vapes the exact same as it does in 18650 mode. The chamber is incredibly reduced. I mean, it's the same. It's the same exact sized chamber. The only difference is the size of it, and it makes it heavy. This is mostly stainless steel. There's no hollow open areas in here. Your airflow channels are longer, but that's about the only difference. Whoa. You know, I made the mistake last week of I grabbed a bottle of what I thought was 6 milligram juice. Turns out it was 12 milligram juice, and I'm trying to lung it out of this marquee, and it's just thrashing me. Just muscular damage. It's just tearing my face off. It was so intense, I couldn't even handle it. And I'm like, this juice is, wow, intense. Turns out it was 12 milligram. Always check your milligram levels. Congestus is hitting nice and hard. The 26650 sized marquee atomizer on top is great. I love the marquee. I do have a video review for the marquee. I feel like it's a really great atomizer with a little bit of a learning curve, but the flavor alone on this is worth the price of admission. The flavor is just stellar, just spiffy, just fantastic. I really enjoy it. So yeah. I'm going to spend a little bit more time with this 26650 Congestus. It is a brass mod, so it's starting to smell funny, and it's getting some serious patina action. In fact, I'm going to take this base off of here real quick and just show you what's going on. A lot of threads. It's a telescoping mod, and like I said, they give you the option to go 26650 on here. This may never come off. I may just be oh, there's the threads. Oh, there's my battery. And so you can kind of see where I've been holding it. Is that going to come across on film? See that dirty stripe right there? That's where I end up holding it. And all the threads that aren't exposed, all the body that's not exposed, is still a nice, shiny, golden color. And it's getting dark and patina-ing right there. Right there, that stripe of dirtness is happening. It is what it is. I mean, it's a copper mod, so it's going to start getting patinaed and coppered like that. What I really like about the Congestus is I like telescoping mods. There's no battery rattle adjustment to do. All you have to do is twist it till it's snug, and that's it. Your battery rattle is taken care of. No harm, no foul, no big deal. The bottom comes off, and it's a typical pin comes down, touches the contact right there. And it fires every time. Haven't had any problems with the Congestus. Obviously, I'll report back in a future video with how it performs sort of in the day-to-day vaping in the real world. But so far, so good. These things are not cheap. 249 euros, which to in American dollars is $284. So you're going to need your vape budget hands hard, but I'm not passing judgment on it yet, because I still need to use it for a little bit longer. I've had it for about a week now, and it's been nice. I'm gonna keep using it. We'll see how it goes. Okay. I was gonna do a first impressions. I guess I'll do a first impressions on this. And where's my Atlantis? I got this mod from SmokTech, and I'm not super pumped on it, but it's not completely horrible either. So this is the XPRO M65 box mod. Kind of looks like the iStick eLeaf, although it's not very comfortable to hold because the bottom isn't rounded. It's very flat, and I find myself not enjoying the way that this holds. One thing that's very weird is, so this is a 0.5 ohm coil. The DNA or the display looks exactly like the old DNA 30 display. Exactly like the old DNA 30 display. If I turn this up to, let's see as high as it'll go, 65 watts. If I turn this up to 65 watts and I wanted for some reason to vape this at 65 watts, it flashes. It says, no, you don't get to vape at 65 watts. Let's try that again. I'll see if I can show you it on camera. 64, 65 watts. Can I zoom in? I just want you to see this happen in real time so you know that I'm not crazy. I'm gonna try to focus. Okay, so it says 65 watts, and then when I press the button, it's gonna flash and go nope, and it turns it down to 60 watts. And if I try to push it again, it flashes and it says no, you have to go down to 55 watts. And if I press it again, it goes no, you go down to 50 watts. And if I press it again, it goes no, you go down to 45 watts. And if I press it again, it says, no, no, you go down to 40 watts. And if I press it again, that's when it fires. So if you try to go way too high with something, I can't vape this coil at more than 40 watts on this. It simply won't let me unless I see, oh, now it'll let me fire at 40 watts. That's fine. I would actually leave it there. But if I wanted to turn it up to 42 watts, it'll still let me fire it. So it'll throw you down into what it feels like is a safe area for you to vape in, and you can kind of work your way up from there. Don't get too greedy, because if you go too high, it's going to go, no, no, I'm going to dump you back down to 40 watts and you can start over and play nice this time. Yep, it just did it. Nope, now it bumped me down to 38 watts. Which actually isn't all that bad, but I'm gonna put it at 40 watts. Now, will it let me fire at 40 watts? Yes, it'll let me fire at 40 watts. I just think it's interesting that if you try to go too high with this, it'll go, no, no, I'm gonna bump you down in some wattage. Am I focused? Yes? Okay. I'm gonna bump you down in some wattage. You're gonna go down. You're going down in your wattage. I also don't like that you have to supply your own 18650 with this. You have to take off the base with the little hex key that they give you, the little Allen wrench, and you take off the whole bottom. You take out these four screws, you take off the whole bottom, you put your own 18650 in there, and then you put the four screws back on. It does charge via USB, but it does not provide you with an 18650. Overall, it's not terrible. It's a nice pocketable little sized thing. It does go up to 65 watts on a single 18650, so it's not gonna give you an incredible battery life at the full wattage. If you're rocking it down here in the 40 watt range on a single 18650, it's gonna work much, much better, but it's fun. It's kind of cool looking. It's just not super comfortable to hold. Just not super comfortable to hold. So we talked about the Atlantis extension, the VapeBoss app. We gave a shout out to everybody and their mother, Dave from eSig Outlet of Muskegon, Michigan, Vape News Magazine, Twisted Messes, Cloud Kicker Society, Congestus XPRO 25. Oh yeah, this is the last first impressions I want to do now that this is running incredibly, incredibly long. This is the Arctic Tank, and this Arctic Tank is made by Horizon Tech. I hate the term killer. Oh, it's a K-Fun killer. Oh, it's a Congestus killer. Oh, it's a Sigelli 100 watt killer. Everyone and their mother, literally, there were mothers, told me this is an Atlantis killer. These come with a stock 0.2 ohm coil. So this is clearly not being marketed or targeted towards brand new vapers, because brand new vapers aren't going to know what to do with a 0.2 ohm coil. I'm currently rocking this 0.2 ohm coil in the Invader version 2 from Tesla, which for some reason I just really like. I got to see the new Vapesmith grippy style unregulated dual 18650 box mod. Looks amazing, but for now I'm using the Invader 2. Parallel 18650 batteries, 0.2 ohm coil in here, have not had a single dry hit the entire time. The airflow is great. I find myself even turning it down. It has four airflow slots, and I just give it a little, just close it off just a little bit. The flavor is great. The wick they use is 100% organic cotton, but that's also what Joytech said about the Delta, and then everybody found some fishy shit in there. So maybe I will rip apart one of these coil heads to see what's actually in there. I am going to do a full review of this, I think. I think this isn't just going to be in the vlog. I think I'm going to do a full review of this Arctic Tank because it's impressed me. One thing that I really like about the 0.2 ohm coil is I can rock it on a mech mod. Sure, you can rock your Aspire Atlantis on a mech mod, but really at 0.5 ohms, it should be on a regulated mod. That's how I like to do it. But this, absolutely, you can rock it on a mech mod. I was rocking it on a single 18650 mech mod earlier. It's nice. I forgot how great it is rocking a tank on a mech mod. I used to rock my K-Fun on my Nemesis all the time. I love rocking a tank like this on a little mech mod. Maybe not this one, but a little mech mod, and still having that great, great, great performance. Flavor, stellar. This is Glacier Banana. I know exactly what it's supposed to taste like. It tastes stellar. The hype is real, I guess. I have enjoyed every aspect of this tank, from the airflow to the coils. The tank, you can fill it up all the way, and it's nice. The airflow is nice. The performance is nice, and I can rock it on a mech mod. This right here, the Tesla Invader 2, with an Arctic tank on there, two Sony 18650s. It's been one of my favorite vapes that I've had in a while. Anyway, that will be my last first impression. I do have something ready to go, so let's quickly do a retro vaping. Oh man, this is going to take some people back. This is going to take some people back. I don't know exactly why I hung on to this for so long, other than when I was using it, I did really enjoy it. Unfortunately, I'm not going to be able to vape it today. Does anybody remember this? Do you see this thing right here? This is the Janti stick, and I'm going to adjust my focus so I can hold it up there because I'm going to be that guy for a second. Do you see this? Oh, look at those lines. Do you see this clear ring around the bottom? That lit up with different colors. There's your fire button on the back right here. It was nice and clicky. The front had this decal that everybody thought was like a grill or a speaker or a vent hole. No, it's just a sticker. Janti, two holes in the top. This is the Janti stick, charged via USB. In the side? I don't remember that, but it did charge via USB on the side. This is the Janti stick. And this was very, very popular for a while on ECF. In fact, I remember, if anybody knows Waldo, dumb Waldo, he got into an argument hard with a guy on ECF about how great the Janti stick is. He loved it, so I thought, you know what, I need to buy this. Battery cover over there, so it held a single 14500 battery. It was about the size of a AA. It fit in one side, and it used a 801 pen style, which I don't have, but I can show you a picture of. Certainly, it used an 801 pen style atomizer. It was this long atomizer, and it fit all the way down into the mod. And there was a little 801 connection down in there, and you screwed it down in there, you popped on your cartridge, you held it like this, and you vaped on it. And I do believe I have a video for the Janti stick. I will link to it in the description to this video, but I do believe I did a video for the Janti stick. And if I didn't, then shit, I didn't, but I believe I did. This was all the talk once upon a time. Did it use it? It might have used a 10440 battery. I don't even know if it used a 14500 battery. I think it used a 10440 battery. But what I loved about the Janti stick is the size. It was small. It was smaller than the screwdriver I had. I liked that it was like a little slender thing that you just put in your pocket and you can drip in there. One of the big concerns with this was dripping. Atomizers leaked out of the bottom, and everyone thought, oh, it's going to leak into the USB. In the later versions of the Janti stick, they sealed it down there so that if it did leak, you could flick it out or get a paper towel and kind of flick it out and get all the juice out of there. I used this a lot. This was my go-to for a while, for two solid months, I would say. This was my go-to vape, was this little Janti stick. I remember I put e-liquid planets, USA tobacco juice or whatever in here. And back then that was the first USA made juice. That's a, what I should get a hold of is a bottle of some e-liquid planet. That was the first USA made juice. And everything before that was China, and now we have 1.5 billion USA juice vendors. But once upon a time, all we had was China juice. Try vaping some China juice now. See how good that tastes. I remember the root beer juice I had from China tasted like potpourri. Like I just jammed potpourri in my mouth, and it was terrible. I loved this thing. It had a very high asking price. Let me try to find a... I wonder if anybody's even selling this anymore. Janti Stick. Janti USA, USA Janti, review of the version 2 Janti stick. Let's see if I can find my video for it. I don't, the Janti 510, nope. Unboxing the Janti stick. There's a ton. Ooh, Parked. Everybody remember Parked before he was a douche? I guess he was always kind of a douche. I might not have a video for this, which is weird. I'm going to look through and see if I can find my review. But if we're on the Janti USA website, stick batteries, stick atomizers, stick accessories, stick cartridges, but not the actual Janti Dura or the Janti stick. They just called them e-cigar batteries. And it was, I believe they were 10440s. I believe it was a 10440. The battery's $3. I can't imagine this was very expensive. I think it was around $50 for the Janti stick. This was it. At one point in time, this was the boss mod to have. And I used it. In fact, I took this. Did I take this to the first Vape Fest? I definitely took it to the second Vape Fest. I remember seeing it in my box that I shipped to myself. Yeah, Janti stick. That thing is crazy. This is a crazy little thing. And unfortunately, I can't vape it. My future retro vaping segments, I'm hoping that I'll be able to vape some of the items that exist. But as it stands, I don't have a 10440 battery. I certainly don't have an 801 pen style atomizer. And I'm just not going to be able to... just not going to be able to vape it. So there you go. Yeah, that's the retro vaping segment. One thing that I want to do right now instead of viewer mail, and this is running long, is I want to talk about music. I'm on Spotify now, and Spotify is great. I love it. I think it's worth every penny that you pay for it because it's got some great new releases on there. What was I listening to? Skate Park Punk. But I'm going to go to my music, and there's this great band that I discovered called Tundra. T-O-U-N-D-R-A. If you're interested in more music, just follow me on Spotify. T-O-U-N-D-R-A. This is 3. Yes. Yes. Oh, it's got the full album, Boss. I'm going to put this on... I'm going to add this to my vlog thing. It's kind of this stonery, atmospheric stuff going on. The whole big, it fades in for like a full solid minute. And then when you get into it, can you hear that? The great thing about this Tundra album, or Tundra, I was first attracted to the artwork. I saw the artwork and I was like, look, that's cool. And then I listened to them and I'm like, I'm glad they're good. Because with that kind of artwork, they need to be really good. This is a great band to put on when you're doing other stuff. I listen to Tundra when I'm answering emails or answering comments or fiddling in Photoshop for t-shirt graphics or Namberjuice graphics and all this stuff. I put on Tundra because it's just this great background music. And every once in a while, you hear something and you'll pause and you'll go, that was really cool. That was really cool. So yes, Tundra. Check out them. I will put a link in the description to that full album. They have the full album on YouTube. Additionally, Fu Manchu came out with a new album that I've been listening to. I'm a huge Fu Manchu fan. And they came out with this new album called Gigantoid. And it's just fantastic. It's... It sounds exactly like you would expect Fu Manchu to sound. They have this, like, California skate rock stonery sound to them. They've been around forever and ever. They're my absolute one of my favorite bands. But they have a new album called Gigantoid. Let me see if I can find that on YouTube as well. I was just going to use my Spotify... Fu Manchu Gigantoid. So there's a song. I'm going to add this to the playlist, then I'm going to link to it in the description to this video if you want to check it out. I love Fu Manchu, but I love all that stonery rock stuff. It's Fu Manchu. The last thing that I wanted to talk about. So I'm a big death metal guy. I like death metal. I just like death metal. I love death metal and black metal and evil shit. And fucking Cannibal Corpse. They came out with a new album and it is stupid good. My good buddy Mark Moots, whom I love to death. I hope you're doing good, Mark, if you're watching this. he's helping me with the Grim Cult line that's coming out. Every year he does a top 10 favorite albums of the year. And he's been doing it for years. And I always read his top 10 albums and I go, okay, yeah, that. Oh, I haven't heard that. Oh, I've heard that. Oh, that's cool. And then this year's, I was like, Cannibal Corpse? Really? Like, I like Cannibal Corpse, but I would never say that they have like these amazing albums or anything. It's like, yeah, Tomb of the Mutilated is great. Sure. Gallery of Suicide's rad. Sure. You know, these albums are great albums, but they're not like top 10 material. And so I was like, Cannibal Corpse? And so he's like, dude, you need to listen to the Skeletal Domain and then get back to me. So went on Spotify, I listened to Cannibal Corpse, the Skeletal Domain. It's just full of death metal-y goodness, and it's catchy. And that's one thing that I've always liked about Cannibal Corpse, is it's catchy death metal somehow. They have like choruses that you can remember. And it's not just, you know, blast beats and Corpse Grinder doing swirly banging. It's like catchy shit that you can actually listen to. So this is High Velocity Impact Splatter. Typical Cannibal Corpse song off their album, The Skeletal Domain. And I just think it's fantastic. Come on, Cannibal Corpse, get rocking. I don't know if this is going to show up. While we're listening... High Velocity Impact Splatter. Yes, there. Of course there's a video for it. I'm going to post the link to this video as well in the description. I'm going to turn that down. I'm going to set that to the side because I just want to hear some Cannibal Corpse in the background. This is a wonderful album. So yeah, I've been wanting to talk about music a lot more, and unfortunately I had to leave out some viewer mail in order to talk about music, but maybe I'll do some trade-offs. We'll talk about music, we'll do some viewer mail. I do have a lot of very cool stuff coming up in the future, including some new tanks that I got. There's a new mech mod that I'm not supposed to talk about yet that is very, very cool. I do eventually want to talk about that NES mod in a vlog. I haven't got there yet. But I do have a lot of cool stuff coming up. There's a lot of mech mods, and mech mod videos don't get views. They simply do not get views. People don't watch mech mod views, and I don't know what it is. And it's worldwide. I mean, mech mod videos just don't get reviews, and it's probably because the market's a little oversaturated. So I'm going to try to make my mech mod reviews a little bit more interesting, try to take, like, I don't know, a different approach to them maybe. But there's a lot of mech mods, a lot of rebuildable atomizers, some new tanks, some regulated stuff. I still owe you guys Segelli videos. A lot of what I like is the half mechs, which are these type of things, which are the, you know, parallel dual 18650 box mods that are unregulated that allow you to vape like a mech. I've become a huge, huge fan of those. But yeah, there's a lot coming up. A lot more vlogs, a lot more beers, and a lot more retro vaping. But that's what I got for now. Thank you so much for joining me, as always. And I never say this, but if you like this video, go ahead and give it a like. As always, feel free to comment and subscribe at your own leisure. I post links in the description as well to my social media, Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. Feel free to follow me on any of there, because it's fun. It's just good times. I love this community, and I love interacting with it. That's what I got. Thank you so much for watching. What am I going to grab? Got to be the El Cabron on the Sick Clouds box mod. Thank you so much for watching, everybody. As always, let's keep on vaping. That was a little bit better. You know that was a little bit better. I hate trying to find the right mouth shape because I'm always like adjusting it. I need to talk to Fresh Skater J, man. There was one. It was better at the beginning. Fuck it. I give up.